Hello friends and welcome again. This video covers a feature of Microsoft Office known as Selection Pane. Selection Pane is mostly used in three major apps of Microsoft Office, which are Word, Excel and PowerPoint. The main objective of this tool is to select objects like shapes, pictures, clip art and word art. I personally use this feature for Word and PowerPoint, where I have to work with several objects in a single document or presentation. So, why would you need this feature and how it may be useful to you? Well, it's one of my favorite tools when working with Microsoft Word and PowerPoint. Let's see how it works. For instance, in this PowerPoint presentation, I have placed several objects in a single slide, and when working with so many objects in a time, it could be hard to manage and arrange each object at the right place with the right timings. So, here is how you can manage multiple objects easily using the Selection Pane. Bring the selection pane by clicking on the Home tab and then click Select drop-down button and then click Selection Pane. First of all, if the selection pane is not clearly visible and small in size, then you can resize it at any given time by moving your mouse near to the vertical scroll, and when the double-sided arrow appears, resize it accordingly. In the selection pane, you will see all the objects that you have inserted in your document, spreadsheet or presentation. Each time when you insert an object, its default name appears in the selection pane. Let's say that if I insert a rectangle, you can see the name in selection pane with a number alongside. It will be very hard for you to remember that what name refers to what object just with their default names. So the first thing that you can do is to give your objects an appropriate name, so you may easily remember and manage objects with their own unique names. To rename an object in the selection pane, click and select the object by clicking on its name and then left click again one more time, and then you can type and give a name of your choice to that particular object. So if you know that you are going to place and work with so many objects, then it will be a good idea to rename each object in your file so you may easily recall objects according to their names. On the top of selection pane, you can see two buttons: Show All and Hide All. It is simple. If you want to hide all the objects within from your file, then click Hide All. And whenever you need all of them back, click Show All. Let's say that I want to change the background of this presentation, but there are so many objects that what is going behind the objects will not clearly be visible. So at that time, you can hide all the objects and can easily notice the effect. Later, click Show All to have all the objects on place. Through Selection Pane, you can also hide and show specific objects alone. As you can see that each object has an I button alongside. So, clicking this I button once will hide that particular object within from your file, and the I symbol will change into hyphen. That means that particular object is no more appearing on the screen. So at any given time, you can hide only particular objects and then can have only those objects on screen you want to work with. For instance, let's say that I want to align and reposition the numbers in this presentation. So I can quickly accomplish this by hiding all the objects and then show each number one by one and can then align and reposition them easily. You can also easily select objects through the selection pane. I mean, let's say that I want to reposition the number 7 without hiding any other object from the screen. If I just go and try to select number 7 within from so many objects that are on top of each other, then it is sure that you always be selecting the wrong object. The easiest way to select an object within from other objects without hiding anything is to click its name in the selection pane, and that object will get automatically selected on the screen, and then you can arrange or can run other commands on that particular object easily. Lastly, you can also select multiple objects easily through selection pane by holding down the Control key and then clicking on specific object names. I hope you will find this video interesting and informative. If yes, then do leave a like and leave your suggestions and comments. Thanks for watching and subscribe to the teacher for more upcoming tutorial videos. Bye and take care.